പിന്നെ ഇവന്മാരും ഞാനും തമ്മിലുള്ള പ്രധാന വ്യത്യാസം ഒക്കെ പറഞ്ഞിരട്ടെ. ശ്രദ്ധിച്ചു, ഇവന്മാര് പല തന്തയ്ക്ക് പറഞ്ഞത്, ഞാൻ ഒറ്റ തന്തയ്ക്ക് പറഞ്ഞത്. ഓക്കെ,
അങ്ങനെ പല തന്തയ്ക്ക് പറയുന്നത് ടെക്നിക്കലി പോസിബിൾ അല്ല കേട്ടോ. എല്ലാവർക്കും ഒരു തന്തയേ ഉള്ളൂ.
A lot of people don't like the word feminism. They ask if it's just about equality irrespective of one's gender and sexuality, then why does it come from the word feminine? Doesn't that just make the word unequal? So let's look at it this way. Feminism actually tries to liberate anything and anyone that is feminine or that is perceived as feminine. Every human being has both feminine and masculine traits. But our society is designed to look down upon the feminine and make it secondary to the masculine. For example, a man shouldn't cry because that is considered feminine. Or a woman shouldn't have a job because she is then challenging the man's authority. The fact is that society only progresses and reaches a state of harmony when we embrace both these sides of the human psyche. Until we do that, we find ourselves constantly at war with ourselves. Kumbhalangi Nights is about this imbalance between the feminine and the masculine. The film is about two households. The first is the home of four brothers, Saji, Bonnie, Bobby and Frankie. A family of fisher folk, their house is small, broken and unkempt. The youngest brother Frankie is ashamed of his house because of not just its condition, but also the people who live in it. His eldest brother Saji runs a shop in partnership with his friend Murugan, but does absolutely no work, either at the shop or in the house. His only engagement seems to be his comical fights with the third brother, Bobby, as each of them tries to prove himself the manly one. Bobby is known to spend his time getting high by the river. The one that Frankie is closest to is Bonnie. The second brother, who is mute, loves Frankie, earns his keep by fishing, but he avoids coming home to fighting siblings. In this family drama, Frankie shows the most maturity as he cooks for the family, cleans for them, and tries to hold them together. He gets this nurturing nature from his love for his mother. He wants to take care of the home like his mother would. Right at the start, he is seen looking at a picture of the Virgin Mary. We'll talk about that eventually. At the opposite end of the spectrum is Simi's house. Simi has lived in this house with her mother and her sister Baby for a while now. But a new addition to her family is her husband, Shammi. The first time we see Shammi is when he's fixing his mustache while looking at the mirror and then removing a bindi stuck to the mirror. This is him removing every trace of the feminine, not just from his reflection, but also the household.
Raymond, the complete man.
Shammi clearly comes from a household where the smallest of things, like riding pillion behind a woman, are considered unmanly. As we see in his brother's case. Simi and Baby's family is clearly progressive, where men don't feel emasculated when they take care of the house. But that harmony is now destroyed by Shammi. Both these households are about to experience a shift in their energies. The first change comes in Bobby's life when his friend Prasant finds purpose as he is in love with Samisha. Through Samisha, Bobby meets Baby. We also learn at this point that he is too proud to earn money from odd jobs. While Bobby finds himself falling for Baby as she works, Baby's eyes truly light up when Bobby throws a fishing net. The two see each other's talents and find respect for each other. The first time Bobby does something productive is because of Baby. The second feminine enters Bonnie's life in the form of Nyla, an American tourist. While Baby challenges Bobby's toxic masculinity, his love for her even influences him to get a job. At the same time, Naila makes the brooding Bonnie truly open up for the first time.
What is so funny?
What I meant is, you know, first time we're hearing a sound coming from his mouth.
But Saji is still missing this feminine presence. We know that he has the ability to accept the feminine when he says this.
ശരിക്കേ ശരിക്കും നമ്മൾ ആണുങ്ങൾക്കാണല്ലേ എടിവേട് വേണ്ടത്. നമ്മൾ ഈ എഴുന്നേറ്റ് നീ ഔട്ടുമല്ല, എഴുന്നേറ്റ് നിന്ന് കാല് കെട്ടി വീഴാന്നെടുത്ത് പെട്ടെന്ന് നീളത്തിലുള്ള കമ്പിയാണെങ്കിൽ മനസ്സിലായില്ലേ, അത് ഇതാവൂലേ. എടിവിടാണെങ്കിൽ കുഴപ്പമില്ലല്ലോ.
ബട്ട് ഹിസ് ഇന്റെൻസ് നീഡ് ടു ബി ദ മാൻ ഓഫ് ദ ഹൗസ് മേക്സ് ഹിം ദിസ് വേ. ബോത്ത് ബോബി ആൻഡ് സാജി അസ്പയർ ടു ബി ദ മാസ്കുലിൻ ദാറ്റ് ദെയർ ഫാദർ വാസ്. ബട്ട് ദേ ഡോണ്ട് റിയലൈസ് വാട്ട് ഈസ് റോങ് വിത്ത് ദെയർ അപ്രോച്ച്. While all of this is going on in one house, the other seems to be dominated by Shammi's ego. Shammi doesn't believe in women having their privacy because he desires complete control over everyone's life. He won't tolerate the smallest interference in his household, and his biggest fear is the fear of a liberated woman. He's even willing to make Simi lose the family source of income for the sake of his ego.
ഇതിലൊന്നും ഒരു കാര്യമില്ല കേട്ടോ, അവര് പോയിട്ട് ഒരു പൊട്ട റിവ്യൂ കൊടുത്താൽ നമ്മുടെ റേറ്റിംഗ് പോകും, ചിലപ്പോൾ നമ്മുടെ ലൈസൻസ് വരെ ക്യാൻസൽ ആക്കും.
ക്യാൻസൽ ആകട്ടെ.
As the gender balance of the house breaks down, so does its positivity. What's interesting is that Shammi runs a barber shop with his brother. We already know that he believes his facial hair defines him. The shaving knife also gives him power over other men's facial hair. Facial hair stands for masculinity. And as Shammi shaves Bobby, he is taking control as the alpha male. Coming back to Frankie's household, in the middle of an argument, Frankie ends up saying that their mother left because of Saji. At this point, Saji triggers a chain of events. He slaps Frankie before his father's picture, as if he were honoring his father. But Bonnie reacts violently to this assault on his baby brother. This triggers Saji to complain about his family to Murugan. When he brings up how his family believes that he doesn't work, Murugan finally has the courage to tell him that this is the truth. But Saji's ego can't handle the truth, as it feels like an attack on his masculinity. He tries to emotionally blackmail Murugan, but ends up losing his dearest friend in the process. The incident leaves Saji feeling numb. But after the situation is dealt with at the police station, this happens. The slap comes a full circle and serves as a wake-up call for Saji. Saji goes to Murugan's house and he finds a picture of Jesus Christ at the threshold. Just as Frankie saw the need for the feminine energy of the Virgin Mary in his home, Saji can see the need for the masculine energy of Jesus in Sathi's life, as she is pregnant without a support system after the death of her husband Murugan.
நீங்க அவரோட கூட பிறந்த அண்ணன்.
Saji realizes at this point how he has let down not just Murugan but all his brothers. At this point, Saji is made to take responsibility for the first time in his life when Sathi asks him to take her to the hospital. A new feminine is born. Now we reach the point where Saji and Bobby finally open up. Saji approaches his most nurturing brother Frankie for help. Frankie takes Saji to therapy even as Bobby opens up to Baby about his family. We find out that Saji and Bonnie are not related by blood and that Bonnie's mother was rescued by Saji's father. At the same time, Bobby fondly reminisces his father's fishing lessons. From the emotional accounts of Saji and Bobby, we realize that they have been aspiring to a toxic masculine ideal of their father rather than his positive masculinity, which led him to take care of his family and pass down the inherited knowledge of fishing. They realize this when they embrace their inner feminine and allow themselves to cry. Meanwhile, Bonnie has brought the first feminine home. Frankie is excited to meet Naila, and this prompts him to take out one of the house's few possessions, the good teacup. Due to Naila's presence, Bobby and Saji have to behave themselves inside the house. Naila brings music and peace into the house. The house is slowly inching towards harmony. At this point, both Saji and Bobby truly become like their father, as Baby makes Bobby understand that his life's true purpose is fishing. And Saji brings Sathi and her baby home, like his father had brought home his stepmother. Interestingly, Sathi looks exactly like the Virgin Mary from the picture, and that is exactly how Frankie sees her when she arrives. He has found the motherly feminine that he had been looking for. The family seems to have become whole, and all the men in the house seem to have become responsible, having embraced the feminine. This peaceful, balanced family finally has the strength to take on Shammi. Shammi at this point has established himself as the head of the house by buttering up his mother-in-law, the perfect tool of oppression. When his extreme toxic masculinity is challenged by both Baby and Simmi, he literally feels cornered. And then his pathological side starts to show. Shammi is the ultimate representation of what happens when the feminine is completely rejected. It is not normal to survive as human beings with a complete absence of either the masculine or the feminine. Only a truly balanced family can take society forward, rescue the feminine from the toxic masculine, and reunite her with her equal, the positive masculine. A family doesn't have to be mama, papa, and child. It can be made of any random group of people, either related or unrelated, as long as they can find the balance between their masculine and feminine sides. Just as a great big sturdy house can feel like a prison, a tiny weak one-room house can become a safe haven. It can go from being a house to a home. Hey guys, I just wanted to clarify that when I say feminine and masculine, it is irrespective of gender, sexuality, etc. Anyone can view themselves as a feminine or a masculine, but the fact is that we all have both sides, and I'm just saying we should embrace it. And thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed this. This is one of my favorite films of all time, so I hope all of you have watched it. And please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And please do share this video, guys. It really helps out. It really helps out the channel. So see you guys next time. Bye.